Hello everyone, Generalist Programmer here. I just want to start off by thanking everyone that has subscribed to the channel so far. It is your support that helps this channel grow and allows me to make more tutorials and great content. So the topic for today is we're going to be looking at RTS City Builder, sort of basic game that I built over a weekend. There's been a lot of interest in it from some of the screenshots that I've shared online, and I thought maybe I'd just go through the process that I used and what I've actually done in order to produce this scene and game. So just for anyone who hasn't seen this yet, just to run through what it's all about, let's run this in Unity. So we've got a bit of, you know, scrolling, and we've got a mini map, and we've got some type of UI for our economy, and there's some procedural generation and some buildings which we can select and place on our map. So a typical RTS style or city builder sort of game has been put together here. Even though this is very basic, it's something that is quite requested and people would really like to know how I did this and how I put this together. I'm just going to run you through some of the components that went into this. So obviously these are all UI elements, and these UI elements were put together in an application called Inkscape with some vector art, which I then exported out as PNGs and then filled in on the UI system in Unity. The minimap over here is a projected 2D texture with a secondary camera which was added. This camera actually sits at the top view, which is now looking down, so you'll see when we do scroll that it actually does update as well with our scene. And these are both UI elements. So for example, these buildings that I've got here, these are very basic little buildings I made in just Blender just to get started with something, to have a prototype. And now when you right click, it'll just deselect it. How I made these icons for the UI is I basically used the FBX files, and in Windows you've got a way of viewing the models, and then I just screenshotted those and then used them as images in my UI. So the other thing that was done in order to create this, it started off with some procedural terrain generation, which started off with a basic mesh. As you'll see in here, we've got our terrain object, and we just have a terrain script which does all the generation of our trees. So we'll edit the number of trees, number of rocks, and the size of our actual terrain. And then we also feed in our different objects which we actually spawn as prefabs. So one of the big things of generating this terrain is the mesh filter. So when you do generate some vertices and geometry for terrains, you need to apply it to a mesh filter so that you can give it vertices and triangles. So just to give you an idea of how that looks, I'm just going to play this again, and I'm going to turn on gizmos here. Now it's just going to be a little bit laggy. You'll see there are little points here on the map which represents the different quads which are made up of triangles. So triangle would be split like this and like this. And then what we do is we apply some Perlin noise to just give it a bit of variation in the heights. The tree placement and the, just get this to stop. Right, there we go. The tree placement is basically completely randomly generated. So what we've got is a bit of scripting which looks at a random point in our vertices, or our list of vertices that we have in our scripting. So if I want to just go back, go into the script itself just to show you around a bit. So what we have is, if I just bring this over, we've got something that just gets a random point in our list of vertices. And then we've got another little method which then does snapping. So we've got this nearest grid point function which then just uses a bit of flooring just to round off any vertices that we select and then snaps them to the nearest X and Z point on our axis. And then with this nearest point, we can then go and generate some trees. So we just grab our objects and we take our number of trees, which we've got in our inspector, and we get the nearest grid point with the get random point. And then we do a spawn of our tree. So that's how that basically was done. So I know a lot of people struggle with the actual placement of objects on the scenes. So the way that was done is an object will basically be placed, but what will happen is there's a ray cast which is taken from the mouse point down to where it intersects with the actual terrain mesh, and then it will actually move this object around. So this is a temporary object in game space which now moves with the mouse pointer. And then once you click, it becomes a permanent object and gets added to the scene, and a new instance of the game object is spawned, which allows us to move it around on the map and then place it again. So this little effect that you see after we place the object, it's a bit of a particle system, very simple. The particle system was created and then just attached to the game object. So when it does spawn, it will call the awake method for the particle system and play the particle system animation or emission when we place our object. The other things you'll see in the scene is just some rocks, same thing. I did this in Blender very quickly just to get some rocks going. And again, we just used random terrain generation in our script over here to generate various rocks, small rocks and big rocks, all using the same method, using grid points and random points in our vertices. Then the next thing that was a problem is building up an economy of some sort. And as you'll see, let's go in here and see skyscraper, for example. We've got some different attributes which I added so the economy would work correctly. So I've got a frequency, how often that this building will produce, say, for example, money, electricity, water, how much population it uses, and what the building costs are. So this drives this entire economy in our city builder game. So you'll see after a little bit of time, this is still a bit buggy because it's not fully implemented, but if you just give it a little bit of time after I've added a few buildings, we'll see that work. So that's just the amount of money that it's bringing in, amount of megawatt hours it's using, and how much water kiloliters it is actually using as well. So that's basically how this was put together. I hope it was useful for you to just get a broad idea of how this works and how you could possibly do this yourself. I do have a course which I'm putting together at the moment, which runs through the entire process from beginning to end on how to actually build this. So if you'd like to check that out, I will leave a link in the description to the actual course. You can sign up. It's free for 2 months. And then you can try and build this yourself as well. So guys, I hope this was useful, and if you liked it, please like the video, subscribe, and hit the notification bell just to get more updates in future. Thanks a lot, guys. Cheers.